Welcome everyone to the back nine here during the opening round of the divisional doubles taking place in Riverside Park in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Gianna McCrae going for a very simple layup. It's really all about position here on this opening hole number 10. This is a par four. You just want to get yourself as close to the water without going in to set up for that second shot. DJ Ellis with a great forehand shot, then Shasta following it up with a backhand. Here's Ken Parks. He's had the hot hand here during the first nine holes, putting in two or three very long putts, keeping his team right there. They have to use his drive because they used Bob's on the previous two holes. Delbert is very happy there with his driver approach, making this par four look easy. And McCrae says, meh, I'm going to go with a turnover putter after just watching you throw a driver.
Get it!
And you can't help but chuckle. McCrae with so much power on that turnover putter shot. And using a full flex here is Shasta Chris, who goes deep of the basket. DJ's getting worked by a goose that had a little bit of an injury in front of us.
Yeah, you do it. Skip. So
plays it off the water, and that's OB. Thankfully, they'll be able to go with Shasta's better shot, which is up near the pin. And Ken's shot comes up just short. You need to get past those flags in order to get inbounds. And I think he was a little bit scared. Bob wanted to make sure that he found the inbounds. He hung it a little bit wide right, but inbounds, that's what's crucial here. And Bob's able to give it a run. This is a par four, nearly 700 feet. DJ is past the basket, playing from Shasta's second shot. And neither of them can convert. So both will be looking at pars. Felber's got a very easy tap in. Johnny's might have been closer. I think Felber just wanted to use his. Shasta cleans up. He's not exactly thrilled with the par. Bob will tap in. Pair of pars and a birdie. And at 388 feet, this has a water carry for most of the hole. And although that looked like it was coming in right at the basket, McCrae's is hung up on the right side. Felberg plays it lower until the wind keeps lifting. Little tree kiss, come on. What does he say? Flash the rings, world champ love, one of those. DJ with raw power out and over with a very impressive forehand. We're here at modified best shot. You can never take the same person's drive three holes in a row. Great shot by Shasta Chris. Ken's gonna turn it over. We'll see if it's got enough room to come back out of it, and it eventually does. All coverage brought to you this weekend here by Latitude 64 and the Professional Disc Golf Association. And Bob's drive is also high and right, hits the tree, but he'll have a putt from there. Ken's putter just fell out from under him there. He has been so deadly with that putter.
Bingo. Bingo.
Oh!
He's inside the circle.
I'm surrounded by dirt.
He's playing some kind of disc golf bingo. I'm not familiar with the game. Bob and Ken with the lonely par. They'll move on. But a huge shout out to Zuga Karts for supporting disc golf. Moving over to the short but technical Peninsula Green, 190 feet, hole 12. Johnny is going to play it to the right, and they have to use his shot.
Oh, darn, I'm out of bounds. Oh, we don't got to play it. That's weird.
And Felberg alluding to they've used his tee shots the last two holes, which is why they have to use Johnny McRae's for this third hole. You can never use more than two tee shots in a row from any player. And both teammates Shasta and DJ find OB. Bob and Ken will take the traditional route out and to the right, trying to get it as close to that pin without finding some of the OB. This is from the McRae's drive. Seriously, what kind of loft was that by Felberg? Solid putt by Dave. And Ken's putter, which could not stop during the first few holes, seems to have slowed down a little bit as Bob and Ken are high and low on that basket. That's a putt from, well, where they were last in bounds, so they'll walk away still with the par. Ceiling here on the 355 footer.
Oh, yeah.
You have the chance to go low and straight at it. However, you may flirt with the OB on the left, or you could take a wider hyzer route, play it down the hillside with a skip. That's what Felberg's doing here.
Nice, Dave.
2, 3, 4 skips and a roll.
That's what you said you were going to do.
So you had me try it. I was like, I have to try that for the tournament.
Oh, that sets up very tough for DJ here. He needs to turn it over more out of his hand on this tee shot. That OB lines the entire left side of this fairway, though. And Shasta pipes it right up the center. He needs it to sit down. It does just before OB. Bob goes out to the right and kneaded it inside that tree. Ken's hoping to pick up for his partner here. He relied on Ken's putter during the first nine. Now he's going to need the driver here. And it's a fighter. That'll give him a look. Just in and out. And that was just in and wanted to come out. And Ken says, two please. I feel like 95% of the putts made have been from almost that exact same distance on the Felberg McRae team. We've got a star frame here on hole 13. Hole 14 is marked at 500 feet. Not sure that it plays all of 500 if it's in fact that far. This is what many would refer to as a very soft par 4. McRae with a smash. And actually puts it pin high or just beyond the basket. Chester Chris needed a little more turn there. Earlier when we saw hole 4, I believe it was, at 530 feet, that was considered a par 3. And this at 500 feet is considered a par 4. I would reverse those numbers, in fact. think this could be considered still a par three. But at the end of the day, it really doesn't matter what par is because the lowest amount of strokes is what counts. Bob's got a very simple approach. Ken's got a green light. He needs to be aggressive. Give that a little higher run. Looks like an eagle attempt there by Shasta Chris. Shasta and DJ, both Team DGA members. Of course, we've got Felberg and Johnny McRae of Team Latitude 64. Felberg not able to draw medal there. And McRae has a look at eagle here. As I said, he's just about basket height. Let's see if he can convert for the eagle. Instead, it's going to be a round of birdies here. A couple of very short tap-ins here on this par 4 500 footer. Question about distance here. This was marked at 200, and after I asked a few of the players, I said, how far is this? And they said, I think it's closer to 300. So I made an executive decision. This is the one hole where I think I changed the distances from the scorecard because it is definitely not the 200 feet. OB on both left and right sides. DJ's turned over forehand finds it. So Shasta needs to put this in play because you cannot have another double OB. Currently see Dave Felberg and Johnny McRae birdieing just about every hole they've played. So far off to a great start, getting every hole on the back nine thus far. Long run from Bob. We'll see if Ken can make it. And running out of luck there, or should I say steam. That also was just short. Shasta's beside himself. He's not sure how in the world he just airballed that. Tap in. McRae. Bob and Shasta are in. Let's move to 16. After getting the first six holes of the back nine, you hear Johnny McRae say, there you go, baby master. Dave Felberg, of course, just becoming of master's age. And now that I think about it, this might have had a longer distance to it as well on the scorecard. And I made the ultimate change to shorten it in terms of what it really is. They must use Felberg's shot, and that was a good one by him. We see both Shasta and DJ throw their shots. This here again, marked as a par four. This is a very, very soft par four. I think most would contend that this is really of a par 3 status, but again, it doesn't matter. You're playing for the lowest amount of strokes. Pair of approach shots. Shasta's got a look here. They had to contend with this one tree, and both gave it runs. And here's Felberg, what would be considered an eagle on the scorecard. And a pair of cleanups by Bob and DJ. Johnny McRae has the tee here on the hole 17, a par 3 at 475 feet. Him and Felberg were talking about the slight change in tee pad positioning. Slightly different from where they had practiced it earlier.
Too much, Johnny. Come on. That's in the water.
Felberg rolls it deep here on this 475-footer. The play from McRae's, who's in bounds. And playing for the full flex shot here is DJ Ellis. What a great shot. The challenge to this hole isn't as much the distance as it is keeping it nice and low and not hitting any of the trees. And that was a beautiful shot by Shasta Chris. Very excited. I would roll off this distance. I'm not trying to downplay Shasta's arm here, and I know it's slightly downhill, but I'm not sure this comes in at a full 475.
Is that safe?
Felberg trying to take over the commentary then. Looking for McRae with a patented turbo putt. Bob's got a long look at birdie. Besides, hey, I'll do some jumping jacks while we're at it. Let's see if Ken can capitalize. Solid run. Ooh, and near face plant by Ken.
Par? What is this?
And we'll see a park job here by Shasta as we go into the final hole, modified best shot.
It's like you guys will let somebody tee off in the last hole first.
They held the box for 17 holes. Let's do it. Easy task for wrapping up here at the Riverside course. They start on an 875 footer and finish on an 800 footer, playing 1 through 18. Just about lunchtime for everyone. It'll be a 1 hour break or so before we head into modified alternate shot. What a crush there by DJ. And Felberg getting a little extra run up here. I want to take as much of this hole as they can here off the tee. Find him left side. And Johnny continues to smash drives. Bob, who's been low and steady throughout, looks like the left side is a little more favorable here for attacking the pin. They had to use Bob's tee shot, so Ken didn't bother throwing a tee shot. And Bob plays a wide turnover that's fading nicely. That is more than a pro-level shot there. That was a gorgeous flight by Bob. And Shasta says, meh. The pole action. DJ certainly has a green light to run this as hard as he wants. And you can't come up short, DJ. Not when your partner's already under the basket. Felberg says he's way left. Well, I think most could handle that. McRae goes for the righty hyzer skip shot. A carded eagle here on this 800 footer. Might be a generous par 5. Felberg's in and Shasta will be in. We'll see you guys for the modified alternate shot. All coverage brought to you by Latitude 64 and the PDGA.